Hello friends, welcome to REC Facts. Today I am going to tell you in miracles of God Sri Guru Raghavendra Swami. Sri Raghavendra Swami was a Hindu god, scholar, theologian and saint. His shrine at Mantralaya attracts thousands of visitors every year. It is a pilgrim village located in Kurnool district in Andhra Pradesh Karnataka border, India. Lies on the banks of the Tungabhadra river.
Sri Raghavendra Swami was born as Venkatanathar in the town of Bhuvanagiri, Tamil Nadu into a Madhva Brahmin family of musicians and scholars. His father Thimanna Bhatta was an accomplished scholar and musician. After the fall of Vijayanagara Empire, he migrated to Kanchi with his wife Gopikamba. Venkatanathar was a skilled musician and a great scholar, but he never demanded any money for his services and accepted whatever was offered to him. Since this happened very rarely, he had little or no means to support his family and had to endure a life of utter, dire poverty. A description of the hardships faced by him will melt anybody's heart. Goddess Vidyalakshmi instructs in dream. That night Venkatanathar had a very strange dream. Goddess Vidyalakshmi herself appeared before him and told him, after feasting on the intellectual treats provided by Sri Madhvacharya, Jaya Tirtha, Vadirajar and others, I am once again starving.
The light of Tattvavada, created by your beloved Sri Madhvacharya, will be extinguished by the darkness of other philosophies. To prevent this from happening, noble souls like you should shed their material bondage and dedicate themselves to the cause of Hari. This is both your duty and your destiny. You are a great soul, destined to provide solace and sakar to millions. You are Sri Hari's beloved devotee and this is what he expects from you. Venkatanathar woke up with a start. He was astounded at what had happened. He closed his eyes to meditate on God, and immediately saw the forms of Lord Vishnu. When he opened his eyes, he saw the world differently. His dilemmas were resolved and he was sure where his responsibilities lay. Corresponding to 1621 AD, Sudhindra Tirtha initiated Venkatanathar into sannyasa and gave him the ashrama name of Sri Raghavendra Tirtha. Nawab tests Sri Guru Raghavendra Swami. Nawab wanted to test Rairu and see if he was really as good as he was claimed to be. He secretly had meat, non-veg prepared and placed on silver plates, but had them totally covered with silken clothes. He took this with him when accompanying Venkana to the puja. Venkana was Nawab's assistant. He offered his covered plates as Navedya for Mula Rama. Raghavendra saw through his guile and sprinkled water from his kamandala on the plates. Later, he ordered the clothes to be removed. The Nawab was waiting for this moment with bated breath. When the clothes were removed, they revealed plates full of fresh fruits and flowers. The Nawab, being Muslim, was astounded and instantly realized the greatness of Raghavendra Swami. And the great sin he had committed by testing this divine personality. He immediately prostrated before Rairu and with tears in his eyes begged his forgiveness. The kind and ever merciful Raghavendra forgave him gladly and Nawab offered villages. But Raghavendra Swami rejected it and he told had no desires for these things. Raghavendra Swami initially refused, saying that he was a sannyasi who had no desire for worldly things, but after Venkana kept forcing him, he finally asked for the village of Manchale, Mantralaya on the banks of the Tungabhadra. Vrindavana Praveshar of Sri Guru Raghavendra Swami. On the chosen day chosen, Virodhikrit Samvatsara Shravana Krishna Paksh Dvitiya 1671 AD, thousands of people had congregated in Manchale to see this rare event of a person entering a Vrindavana alive. Major incident after Vrindavana Praveshar. Sri Thomas Munro converses with Guru Raghavendra Swami. While Raghavendra Swami had his Vrindavana Praveshar around 1:30 p.m. in 17th century, it is recorded in the Gazette of then Madras Presidency that he gave darshan and spoke to Sir Thomas Munro, a civil servant of British government, and discussed with him the restitution of the Inam lands to the government, which was being proposed then, meaning that Mantralaya would have become part of the tax-free lands. After such a conversation, which Sir Thomas Munro dutifully declared, the restitution was withdrawn. Okay viewer, this is the story and miracles of Guru Raghavendra Swami. There are lots of facts to talk about Guru Raghavendra Swami. Thanks for watching the video and please support, like, subscribe and share for more videos. Don't forget to turn on notification bell icon. Take care friends, bye.